Hey, welcome, Forex Fortune Hunters. Tom Wilmot speaking. And I promised a couple of videos on the fundamental announcements that were happening on Thursday and Friday of this week. It's now the 7th of March, Thursday, and the euro got toasted. So let's see how our trend magic double whammy indicator helped us enter and stay in that trade. Okay, let's set the stage on this one. We have a chart here of the EUR.USD 5-minute. And basically, as I mentioned, this is March 7th, a Thursday. Here was the London session, and you could see nothing much happening in terms of the euro during that 2 a.m. Boston time to 7 a.m. Let's open the U.S. market kind of indicator here on our session times chart. And by the way, just recorded a new video on session times and when it's best and worst to trade this market, the Forex market in general. That's been posted to the YouTube, Vineyard FX site. So please feel free to check that one out. But in any event, here we are at 7 a.m. this morning, Thursday, and we're anticipating an announcement of the interest rate, whether they're going to cut it or keep it at zero, and in fact, they kept it at zero. And then follow on to that, Mr. Draghi would have his press conference at 8:30 this morning, Boston time. And I put an indicator here, this blue line indicates 8:30. This was our typical session times indicator for the opening of the U.S. market, the New York Stock Exchange. So what I suggested in an email I fired out this morning, and I was pretty late with it, so I apologize for that. But bottom line is we have a situation where I would go to a 1-minute chart of this market in order to try to stay with the very kind of volatile moves that are involved. I wouldn't use 1 minute all the time, but clearly with a 1 pip kind of spread, 1.5 pips on the euro USD, using a 1 minute isn't going to get you into too much trouble. So here's, once again, on the 1 minute, here's our 3 a.m., 2 a.m., Boston time, London open. We had a little bit of a move to the north, just mostly chopping around, trying to figure out what would happen next. And now we move into the 7 o'clock hour, and you can see as we approach that, we're getting a downdraft. Then we stay in this zone right here with nothing happening from 7 until 7:45, when that announcement on the interest rate was first made. So if we come here, we can see that this is the downdraft that occurred when they kept interest rates exactly at zero, that intraday banking interest rate that is used by the European Union. In any event, this market ends up being at, 12:45. I'm getting my glasses out here, 12:45, which is that 7:45 5-hour difference. So as soon as that announcement was made, we had the downdraft. And what I said was, don't get involved here. Use your 1-minute chart. And you can notice here what happens and how good this was to us. We pulled back. We had kind of a difficult situation. We're underneath our Ichimoku cloud, but this is not clear whether it's going to reverse and go higher. So we wait on this 1 minute chart until we get the next set of double red lines. Here's our chandelier. Here's the trend magic. And our first entry, even on a 1 minute, you can see that if this were 32nd, which doesn't get offered in MetaTrader, if you were on a 32nd chart, you might be able to pull into this area right here and get into the trade. But for sure, we had a push back into this area here. And so if we were to take a look at what happened just on the interest rate announcement, we get back in here, we had a 16, 18 pip drop into the 8:30 hour when the news conference began. And clearly there wasn't any good news there. We had a continued drop and a downdraft. Pulling away from here during the news conference, off we go. Down below all of this, no reason to get out of this 1 minute trade because clearly we haven't even really challenged the chandelier stop. We come into the 9:30 hour, And we have a situation here where even in 9:30 with one pullback, we're rejected again, twice again, another time. And then it isn't until pretty nearly, let's see, what time is it now? About 10:30 that we get into a situation where at least we're back and challenging the cloud and have a double white line. So let's stop back here and see what the pip differentials are. We'll take a look at this one right here with our trusty crosshair cursor. And we can see that in this case, we had a 34 pip decline. Now, also, you can check this out on EUR.JPY. And what I did here was to take a look and add a little Fibonacci to this as well. Notice that this continued on. It didn't even stop at a this original move to the downside. We took that out and continued lower and lower. Usually you'll get a break about 1618. This is a 1618 line right here. And you can see we did pause here, but clearly the market just continued to soften, and the Euro JPY really took it on the chin this morning. So here we go. Let's take a 5-minute chart here. I'm going to get rid of the Fibonacci so it's a little easier to see. And we're going to take a look here. Even if we were to come in at 9:30, the U.S. market with this kind of a pullback here, right here at the 9:30. Remember, we said this is when the new mint money hits the market. We have a downdraft here of some 64 pips on our euro in a 5-minute time frame without ever even getting above trend magic on the 5-minute chart. And let's see whether we have any kind of real big pullbacks here on the 1-minute. Here we go over into there's our 7 o'clock hour, our 8:30 hour. And notice, even on a 1-minute trade, there's absolutely nothing to get you excited about anything until you hit this level way back over here. And that would be in the, let's see, it's 15:05. So that's a 10 o'clock time frame. So just a complete smasheroo job on the euro this morning. And it's clear that our trend magic kept us in the trade and gave us a pretty good entry point too. So hope that helps. And keep in mind, tomorrow's the jobs report, Friday, the 8th of March in the U.S. See what happens. And I would also recommend you go back, because there was a Canadian interest rate announcement with an equally impressive capture by the Trend Magic Double Whammy indicator earlier this week, Tuesday, Wednesday, I've forgotten exactly now, but you can practice by pulling that up on your 1-minute chart and seeing how well our indicators helped us keep trading with the trend. So let's get some pips, Forex Fortune Hunters. Subscribe, like, tell us what you need, comments. And if you hit that subscribe button and the alarm bell, you'll get alerted to new updates and new videos. Thanks a lot.